I'm Martha Stewart, and I am wearing particularly heavy makeup today because we're going to talk all about coffee. You know, I don't actually drink coffee. I liken it to licking the bottom of a cigar ashtray. But for many people, especially the people who work around me, they seem to love it. And I enjoy making it. So the first thing that you are going to need is some high quality coffee. Now my preference is Pete's. You know, in the past, you may have seen me promoting another brand, but I'm not doing that anymore. Pete's is the way to go. Then you will need a bean grinder. I love Krups or Krups, depending on which part of the country you're from. You will also want to get a kettle. My kettle is from World Market. I just absolutely love this fake copper. Now, the first thing you are going to do is pour some water into your kettle. I like to have mine filtered with Brita. After you put the water in the kettle, you're going to turn on your stovetop, or you could use an open fire, I suppose. Just make sure that you boil the water to 212 to 214 degrees. While the water is boiling, what you can do is run the grinder. I don't actually put beans in here. I just get the ground coffee because it's so much simpler. But this is a nice sound, and it lets your guests know that you care. Then what I do is get the French press. Hold on. Never mind the French press. The French press is basically just a pitcher with this thing on top of it. You put a couple of scoops of your ground Pete's coffee into your French press, and then you pour the hot boiling water on top, stir it around a bit, shove that lid thing down after a few minutes, and then you can pour it into your favorite cup or mug. I think mugs are actually hideous, like this one, and particularly this one. I would never buy this ginormous mistake of a cup. This is much better, this one from Crate and Barrel, although I don't know if I would totally recommend it just yet. I love beautiful teacups handed down to me by my ancestors. I don't want to bother getting them out right now because we're just talking about coffee. And again, it's not one of my favorite beverages, but for addicted Americans, it is a must-have. I'm Martha Stewart. Oh, and I forgot, if you're going to drink your coffee and want something delicious, Girl Scout cookies. I bought mine from Troop 1137, but I don't have a preference on the troop number. I'm just saying Girl Scout cookies are wonderful. And I don't think, as of yet, they have an ambassador. Coffee, heavy makeup, and Girl Scout cookies. Very good things.